Isoproterenol is an important topic. It is 3 out of 5. That means you should probably know a little bit about it for your tests, your boards, your exams, things like that. Its brand or trade name is Isopro. It is a synthetic, non-selective, beta-adrenergic agonist. Now, synthetic means that it is not produced naturally in the body. We do produce this medicine in a lab through a reaction that is similar to the way that we produce epinephrine. You can see that the structures are similar. And lastly, this is a beta-adrenergic agonist that works on both the beta-1 and beta-2 receptors. Next up is the mechanism of action, or the effects of isoproterenol, physiologically speaking. Again, this is a beta-1 and beta-2 stimulator. So remember back to what beta-1 does. Beta-1, I want you to think about heart effects. That means beta-1 is going to cause an increase in the heart rate, or the chromotropy, and in the force of contraction, which is called inotropy, and the speed of conduction through the heart, which is called dromotropy. That's going to lead to an increase in the cardiac output and the systolic blood pressure. Next is the beta-2 stimulation. Isoproterenol used to be used as a bronchodilator in cases of asthma. Now it's not used as much anymore since we have albuterol, but the effects would have been the same. So why do you think we stopped using isoproterenol as the go-to drug for asthma? Well, it's because albuterol is selective for the beta-2 receptors. That means albuterol has less side effects. You can imagine if you gave someone isoproterenol to help their asthma, they would have, in addition to bronchodilation, the cardiac effects, which is really undesirable. What else does the beta-2 stimulation do? Well, beta-2 receptors, when stimulated through the body, cause a dilation in vasculature throughout the body, such as in skeletal muscle, things that need more blood when you are in the middle of a fight or flight response. This vasodilation is actually going to cause a decrease in the peripheral vascular resistance, and thus there's going to be a little bit of a decrease in the diastolic blood pressure. Okay? So let's go over to our chart and work through this. First of all, try not to cheat by looking over at the bullet points. Heart rate. Heart rate is definitely going to go up. We talked about this already. Beta-1 stimulation from isoproterenol is going to cause the heart to beat faster. Blood pressure. What is the systolic blood pressure going to do again? It's going to go up. Again, this is a beta-1 effect. The heart is pumping harder and faster. What is the diastolic pressure going to do? Well, that's actually going to go down. It's going to go down because of the beta-2 effects that are causing the peripheral vasculature resistance to decrease. Okay? I hope that makes sense. If you have questions, remember, you can just let us know, and we will explain it better. Lastly, let's go over the uses and the side effects of isoproterenol. So, it is used to help mainly problems with the heart. Remember how we talked about how we don't really use it for asthma anymore? And why? It's because of the heart side effects, remember? There is still some use for it for things like a complete heart block or bradycardia, which is when the heart is beating very slowly. And that's because it has very powerful beta-1 effects, causes the heart to beat harder and faster. What about the side effects? The side effects are actually related to that. The side effects are similar to the effects of epinephrine or other very strong stimulants. Basically, if someone has a heart that is prone to arrhythmias, maybe an elderly person, isoproterenol could cause the heart to beat too fast or go into a dysrhythmia. And that would obviously be, in addition, a risk for a possible heart attack. Okay, so let's keep these in mind. Dobutamine is another selective beta agonist. However, unlike isoproterenol, which we've just been talking about, isoproterenol, which equally stimulates the beta receptors, dobutamine favors beta-1 over beta-2. So what would be the difference in the physiologic effect between these two drugs? Dobutamine would increase the mean arterial pressure more, or isoproterenol would increase the mean arterial pressure more. The correct answer is A. Dobutamine would increase the mean arterial pressure more. And that's because it would stimulate the beta 2 receptor less. And remember, beta 2 is dilating things peripherally, dilating blood vessels in the skeletal muscle, for example, also in the heart. So you could argue that maybe isoproterenol would be a little bit safer to give someone who has stenotic vessels in the heart, just because it would help dilate those while the heart is being asked to perform more work because of the beta 1 stimulation. Isoproterenol probably keeps the MAP about the same, if not bringing it down a little bit. Remember, we talked, diastolic goes down because peripheral vascular resistance goes down, which counterbalances the increase in systolic blood pressure. Dobutamine is going to increase the pressures across the board. Good job.